Filthy Business has been receiving rave reviews across the UK, and now Auckland Theatre Company present their own take on the hilarious family comedy. Our very own version is directed by the incredible Colin McColl and stars award-winning actress Jennifer Ludlam. Actors Holly Hudson and Andrew Granger are here with us now to tell us all about it. It is great to have you guys here. Welcome. Hi. Before we kick into this, though, this is fascinating because we just had Stacey Gregg on before.
Yeah.
Talking about her book, and she said your pony was the only pony in New Zealand that they've ever used on the cover of that book.
Yeah, he was. He was the only one picked. They did lots of pictures with lots of different New Zealand horses, and he was the one that got through to the final round and got published.
How weird is that?
The cafe bringing everyone together.
That's so weird. Yeah. But you, how did you get into acting? What was your sort of background?
My dad is a journalist, and I think, you know, having him telling stories around me all the time and growing up with someone who was very inquisitive really got me into telling stories as a medium, and I really I sort of just loved the playfulness of acting and the freedom, and every new job is a new exciting thing. Yeah.
And I bet he was also probably saying to you, don't get into journalism and say, well, I'm going to be an actor. So he would have
thought
that.
Yeah, exactly. He actually was. Yeah, yeah, pretty much.
And Andy, looking at the list of things that you've done overseas before you came to New Zealand, so impressive. We're talking Heartbeat, EastEnders, The Bill, The Governor, Pride and Prejudice.
Yeah.
That's just to name some of the TV stuff you've done.
That's right. Yeah, I did the rounds there, that's for sure. More than once, actually, as well, because, you do want like EastEnders or Heartbeat or something, and then, you know, 2 years later you come back, you know, different beard, same character.
If you're the same character, that's pretty good. So what would be some of your highlights, do you reckon, in your career?
There's been a few, actually.
Yeah, I've just been reading the list.
On film, even though I had a tiny, tiny part, I did a scene with Robert Redford.
What happened?
It was Spy Game. And it's a tiny scene, and I remember we were, you know, on set, huge set. Tony Scott was the director, and there were two, you know, chairs with your name, my name, and Robert Redford. And I was sitting there going, oh my God, what can I say? And I couldn't say anything, and he just looked at me and went, hell of a way to make a living, huh? I went,
What a moment.
I know.
What were you to New Zealand?
Well, it was my wife. I met a Kiwi. Yeah. I met her in Los Angeles, getting over my first wife. And, she used to work for Air New Zealand, and she used to fly in, although living in London, she used to fly in, and I was staying with friends, and we met, on Sunset Boulevard.
Oh, well, nice to have you here. Yeah. Clearly things have not slowed down with the acting since you've been in New Zealand.
No, it's been great. It's been really good. I think I hit that kind of middle-aged bloke that can sing and dance a bit.
Well, that's good, and that's what you want to be.
Yeah.
So the story, Family Business, is about a...
Filthy Business.
It's about a family rubber business, isn't
it?
And so, obviously, the English playwright Ryan Craig, his family was in the rubber business, so obviously a bit was based on his own experience.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah? Definitely. It's some of the stuff in the scenes, you just can't, like, write that. It really seems like real... the dynamics, you go, this is an actual family with the writing and the relationship.
Yeah, it's great. It's really kind of dense kind of writing, but also really comedic, very comedic. I think he's fourth generation Jewish.
How was it Filthy Business?
What do you mean? How is it?
Well, how is it like Filthy Business? Is it like a really filthy business?
Oh, of course, yeah. It was very filthy business. Yeah, everything rubber, rubber, you know.
Yeah.
Anything you want.
Yes, sorry, just got it.
Yeah.
Took a moment. Ding, bell's gone off.
That's right.
Well, okay, so tell us more about the characters you play. So, who do you play, Holly?
I play a young woman called Bernice who is growing up in the sexual revolution.
Oh, yeah.
So she's. She feels quite liberated about her sexuality, I think. she is quite boisterous, quite stroppy.
Doesn't really like to put in work anywhere, just kind of floats about and loves a bit of glamour.
She likes her hair.
Loves her hair.
What a great role.
Yeah, she's fun. She's very funny and she's very fun to play. I love an unapologetic woman to play on stage, yeah.
And Andy, you play Bernice's dad?
Yes, I do. I play Nat Solomon, who's the eldest son of Yetta, who's played by the lovely Jen Ludlam, who's fantastic, always great. I've played her husband, and I've played her brother-in-law, and now I'm playing her son in the past. So it's really good. It's really good. Yeah, and he's a... he's a dark, quite a dark character. He really feels that he should be running the company, having more to do with the company. Very jealous of his brother, Leo, played by Adam Gardner, who's great, who went to war. He managed to go to war and come back a hero, and Nat didn't manage to go to the war because of something happened to him, which you can find out if you come and see the play.
Oh, nice tease.
So it's a really kind of dark kind of secret there, past there. Mm. So he's quite angry. And he deals with everything with his fists, really.
And Filthy Biz has been a smash hit in the UK. Mm. As actors and actresses, do you wish that you could go and see it over there to take on what it means? Or do you like to sort of go into the concept raw, develop your own style?
I would really love to go to the East End and see the culture there and really, like, absorb that, but I'm not sure if it would be particularly helpful to see someone else play the same character because it might influence you. I don't know.
Think always the way you've always got to bring yourself to something. Yeah. That's what you are. That's what you're selling. Mm. But for me, what's great about it, I mean, I lived about 3 or 4 miles away from where this is set, so I know the people. I know what they were like. These big Jewish families who were really friendly and lovely to you, but you cross them.
Mm. You know.
Yeah, you don't get away with it. Yeah, it's hard. It's hard. Hard business as well, and especially because it's set in 1968. It's a very different time.
True.
So a little bit historical as well, is it?
Yeah. From 68 to 81, don't we?
Yeah. About 13 or 14
good
years.
Good times. So the costumes must
have been great. Fantastic. I mean, we have to age 13 years, don't we? So I play from 20 to 34.
That's okay.
Yeah.
Tell us a little bit about Colin McColl. What was it like working with him?
This is my second time working with him, and you've worked with him a lot more, but he's really great at guiding you to a decision rather than, telling you what to do. And it's not about, like, he'll kind of do it through asking questions rather than telling you, like, stand here, say it this way. So it's a very, it feels like an exploration rather than doing blocking.
Feels like you've made up your own minds on how to do it, doesn't it?
But it does, that's right. Yeah, it's a really clever way of doing it, actually, and gets the best of humour. Mind you, he has, chucked a couple of tennis balls at me now and again.
Yeah, he does, but he chats. He's just constantly...
He's a chatter.
He's a chatty cafe.
He's worked with Robert Redford. There's some good stories to hear. it looks like a fantastic show, and I can't wait to see it. So best of luck with the season, guys.
Yeah, good luck. Thank you for coming in.
14th to the 29th.
I'm going to do all that bit now. Don't you worry about that.
You're right, Holly. He is a chatter.
Filthy Business runs from next Tuesday until the 29th of August at Auckland's ASB Waterfront Theatre. You can check out the Auckland Theatre Company website for ticket details.
And look, that was just 4 minutes with them, and how much fun was that? You can imagine a whole couple of hours.